It's about a detective and his assistant and their struggle to solve a crime.
Enjoy.
Sir, what time did the murder take place?
I don't know.
So, are we to call forensics?
No.
Then how should we investigate?
The time of the murder, and the victim. It's not important. What is important is the motive.
Let me take notes.
Once you know the motive, fuck it, you can find the murderer. And the murderer will tell you himself who needed murder and when.
So, do you know the motive?
Yes.
What is it?
Kayla was suffering.
How do you know that?
The motive is always suffering. Write that down.
Yes, suffering from what?
Bad body odor.
What?
Yes.
How do you know that?
I smell strong cologne at the place of the murder. It's not used by anyone without presence at the murder site.
I can't.
And that's why you, or the assistant, are the detective. I've done a shot before, but call me a detective.
Okay, so we know the victim was murdered because the murderer was suffering from bad body odor.
Then the victim was murdered. It was suicide. I'm not sure if these people are suicide myself yet. You said you read it when I interviewed you.
Yes, I mean I forgot.
So, we either have two options. One, the victim committed suicide and someone with cologne ran away from the scene. Or two, someone with cologne murdered the victim.
So, how do we know if it was murder or suicide?
It depends upon the length of the feet of the victim and the distance at which the head was found away from the body.
The head was found in the other room.
And that is how far?
10 meters.
So according to my calculations, the width of the saw is 13 feet, can go his or her as 8 feet. So in this case, the victim is a wife and a dancer. At least, that's what we conclude by the dress she's wearing. This is Bubba.
Sir, you are a genius.
Emma was blessed to the same IQ. Heart was just blessed with a whole lot more.
So how do we find the murderer?
We already know the murderer. You see, bad body can be bad for following three reasons. One, the person has a major in biology. Two, the person eats spicy food. And three, the person has a certain medical condition like chickenpox.
And who is that?
Her husband has chickenpox.
How do you know that?
I count the number of times he ordered chicken in a restaurant.
But what about the spicy food?
Now you know why I stopped at the Spice Palace restaurant next to his house.
Sir, well, great. What about the cologne?
I saw it in his restroom.
But the court needs proof.
That's how an eyewitness nailed this guy.
Okay.
You've come along so well. Let's go to the next case.